epiphanies out there. I think I've lost like 3 pounds, so it's not really been a lot. All of this. Yikes. Anyway, yeah, the raw vegan, I've been a lot of raw vegan lately, everything raw, trying to really not even have cooked beans. I made the sprouted garbanzos. Those actually are kind of okay as a hummus. But then to make a real hummus, you have to add so much oil. So I made a fake hummus with very little oil, and it's still not as tasty. But I want to talk about the thymus. Actually, I've been reading about it, and I saw like a little blurb out there yesterday, and somebody was saying that it's located. Actually, a lot of sites are saying it's located behind your collarbone here, and the people are having them thumped now. They're going in to the thymus specialists, and they're having them thumped. So, or they're thumping them themselves, you know, because they release. Apparently, they release your consciousness. They release your happiness. So if you're having an upset to your happiness, apparently, if you thump it, you can all of a sudden get that endorphin in back through. But more important, we have to discuss, no, that's incorrect. You cannot just run around and thump at it. Because this little doll that's here, these thymus glands, they are born with us, okay? And then they peter out when we're about 65 years old. You know, funnily enough, the time that they made the social security number, yeah, the original one, yeah, they peter out when we're 65 and we don't have the thymus anymore to draw from. Now, the thymus was so important all through our life, those 65 years. It's like the immunity. It's the T-cell releaser, okay? So our T-cells, I don't want to talk about T-cells, but yeah, lower count T-cells, higher count T-cells, they're all here. So if you're thumping at them, trying to, hey, give me my T-cells, you're gonna wear yourself out. You're not gonna have any T cells left. It's like a woman who drops too many eggs in her menstrual cycle. She's not gonna have. I don't even know if they can do that, but yeah, she's not gonna have pregnancies, chances later on. You know, so it's you can't be taking away from your bank. You know, this is your thymus bank, and so people are trying to take away from it. And it's no in wrong in a way. It's there's nothing you can do about it. If that's your immunity there's nothing we can do. That's our body physical situation. But when we're getting into how come my thymus right now at this age isn't really delivering happiness, because it's really a happiness deliverer, how come I'm not getting that enough? Okay, so I was reading a little about the intestine, where the thymus has a bunch of its energy drawn from. It draws a bunch from the small intestine. So you have nothing to do with the colon, nothing to do with the stomach, it's just the small intestine. And in that, when it has everything cleared out and it's in good shape and it's in good form, you actually, I mean, if you really are in tune with your body, you can get yourself to, hey, I'm laughing, and I'm just laughing. I felt funny, I felt humor, I felt a giggle, I felt a humorous thought, and I just laughed. And so this type of release, that's you in your body, that's you in your body, that's your intestine zone saying, hey, I'm happy. Things are going good down there, and it's all heading through beautifully to how many miles we have in there, I don't know, but we have a lot. And I'm sorry to those of you who've had operations, yeah, appendectomies and cesareans, sorry to you, because I do know that scar tissue can interrupt quite a bit. that flow. One woman said to me, she was like an iridology doctor once, and she said, you have a kink in your colon and you're never going to get rid of it. And that goes back to that a kink in my intestinal colon zone. So not the colon itself, it was higher up, but she said that it was because of that operation. And when they pulled it all out and they stuck it back in, you know, things get twisted. So that's my thing going on, but a lot of you have had these operations, so you can imagine things are twisted in there or rearranged, and so your flow is just not so normal any longer. It's been upset. So when we're talking about the digestion and the happiness zone and this thymus getting its T cell release, your T cells are released when that intestine is having its happy clearance. So it's kind of like you can't have T cells released just by thumping on them. You have to have that intestine also doing its duty. Okay, doing its so when you're talking about the raw foods, then you have a much higher chance of delivery to the body, you know, of things digesting properly and not becoming glues like 4 or 5 days ago, I had a little bit of flour and I was going off and I added flour into something. And the next day, I just felt terrible. So it really does affect you once it hits your digestion. And it made me feel terrible, like depressed. So there is a personality serotonin releaser there, your serotonin happiness. So anyway, that was just kind of a neat thing. So if anybody is working on their T cells releasing and getting the most out of them, we have to think about the intestine in conjunction. And also, so we're getting into consciousness now. And they talk about the thymus gland as being your fourth chakra. Okay, it's your fourth chakra, it's your heart chakra. Love is there, and unconditional love is there, which is a big, major enemy for a lot of us. Unconditional love is almost like, you gotta be kidding me, who wrote this chakra list? I almost wanna choke them. I mean, that's impossible. Unconditional love, it's just absurd. So anyway, so I guess I may be stuck at the fourth forever. No matter how much indigo paint I get into, I will be stuck at that fourth because I'm not an unconditional love type. I'm sure most of you are not. No. And so anyway, so we're at the consciousness though. A higher level of consciousness now is happening with this immunity, your immunity release, your immunity access. You have to talk about it as access to you're getting access. You could just have some T cells that are there sleeping and lying, and they're not going to do anything. They're not going to give you enough, and you can die before you're 65. You know what I mean? When you needed that immunity, because you're so blocked and bogged down in that intestinal zone. So we're talking about it's maybe higher up, but the other has to be really dealt with correctly. So it's kind of a fascinating, cool. But then I'm also like, okay, 65, and then what happens? There's no more T cells being created. The thymus is done. It said, basta pasta, it's over. I'm done. I'm turning off. I'm not going to be there anymore for your immunity. So it's almost like the saddest thing ever. In reaction to that, the only thing we can do is try to avoid being 65. Like forever, you know, keep that age away from us, keep our organs as young as possible, keep what's on the inside of us as young as possible, for as long as possible. And then maybe we cheat the thymus and we gain extra immunity into 70, 75, I don't know. That's where I'm at right now with it. But yeah, it's a tough thing. So once you hit 65, they're saying that's it. You're not going to have any more T cells raining from the sky. And then we start to see, you know, the grouch syndrome that goes on with men and women the older they get. Bitter. This didn't happen. That didn't happen. My life just didn't go well. Well, you don't have any more T cells either. So it's very interesting, isn't it? And I don't, you can't go to the store and pick them up and shoot them in. I'm sure they're trying, though. I'm sure they would be trying to do something as silly as. But anyway, so that was my update on that hoo-ha. Didn't mean to depress you all. If you're 64, I did not mean to depress you that you only have one more year of immunity left. But it is something to read about and really take your health seriously. You know, what you eat, what you digest, that input.